What's good, YouTube land? I'm gonna play the song again. You're my. I would play it the whole time. But... Oh. I don't give a shit about copyright. Okay, that's enough of that. But next up in our mini return to McFarlane Mortal Kombat toys, it's the Speedster Cabal. Can I finish this review lickety split? How many speed puns can I toss in one video? I don't know! But I do know that I'm reviewing this toy. And I wasn't going to do the matching gimmick again, but I forgot to change shirts in between recordings. Oh well. So yes, this is Cabal as he looks in Mortal Kombat 11 at the start of Mortal Kombat 11. Because we have to get into that for a second. That is a very nice shot of him just holding his weapons, though. So, yes. Cabal. Oh, Cabal. Alright, so for a bit, I'm going to get into Mortal Kombat 11 spoilers, so if for some reason you're one of the weird people who haven't played Mortal Kombat 11 yet and plan to, feel free to skip ahead. I'm not going to put a timestamp because I don't know how it works, but basically, I'm going to go into spoilers. So, yes. This is Cabal in his Revenant form. Oh, this is also going to be slight spoilers for Mortal Kombat 9. So if you also don't want to hear those kind of spoilers. So at the end of Mortal Kombat 9, or which was it? Yeah. Basically, in Cabal's story, in the reboot, he was a cop, got burned alive by one of the Shokan, I believe it was a... Not Goro, but Kintaro. Kintaro burned him alive. Except for his hair, somehow. He managed to maintain his hair. So, he was kept alive by a breathing apparatus made with Outworld magic, thanks to Shang Tsung, which gave him the ability to run fast. Because even that is a better backstory than the Flash. Freaking hard water and lightning my ass. So, but by the end of the game, he died. Killed. And he starts MK11 as a Revenant, which is this toy, which is basically somebody who's been brought back to life, a zombie, sort of. But brought back with Quan Chi's magic, so they're evil. And then they do the whole go back, they bring a pre-burn Cabal back in a later chapter of MK11. And I think that's where his story ended. I can't remember off the top of my head, but yes. So this toy is a toy of his Revenant form. I already mentioned that. So he has gray skin, bluish gray skin. That's really the only difference. Oh, and he has a mask that somehow has red eyes, which I'm guessing is his face now, because he shouldn't need it as a Revenant. Frankly, in my opinion, he died, was brought back to life, the magic keeping him alive. He shouldn't need the breathing mask now unless it has literally become a part of his body. Cabal, you are so over designed. But it's definitely the best Cabal has looked, because his MK9 designs were not good. But he's got a little breathing pack back there. He's got, what's that? A poncho, a skirt, clothes under it. He's got too much going on. Random armored knee pads and gloves. And Cabal's also worked for the bad guys pre-Revenant by being a member of the Black Dragons, like working for Kano. And I believe his first name is actually Carlos, because I believe there's a pre-fight where Johnny Cage calls him Carlos, and then I believe that's actually because his first name is Carlos or something, or close to that. I forget the story there. Cabal is just—he's just a bit too much. Barely any personality other than "screw you, I can go fast," and he's just wearing too much clothing. We have to review what's here, not complain about it. So that head sculpt is, well, I guess as accurate as it can be, because it's a face mask. And his hair. He got burned over 99% of his body. The 1% that didn't get burned, his hair. Somehow he did not lose all his hair follicles. Because even in the MK9 design, he has a freaking super long ponytail. Like, at least he does have a ponytail now, but like, how did his hair not get burned off? How was he able to regrow hair if it did get burned off? These are questions I didn't think I had until I looked at this. Although it does have some nice molding in it. And yeah, we're not gonna keep talking about all this stuff. We're just gonna go into posability, which his head is on a ball joint. Very free range. Look up that far, look down that far, side to side, and swivel here. You can go 360. Shoulders go out. Back. Oh. Can't say I expected that. There we go. It's not even a mushroom peg. I don't even know what kind of joint that is. It's just that. Thankfully, the joint holding it is just flexible enough to wedge it back in, please. There we go. That's a little bit scary. But they can go all the way out. On, other shoulder, go all the way out. There we go. You do get a bicep swivel. You also get a butterfly joint. So you can go all the way around and bit of in and out, bit of on the shoulder. I don't know about that joint, but you do get a double jointed elbow, which has very nice bend ability. And you get a wrist swivel, which is also a hinge. In the hinge. And the hinge and the hinge, which is really good for swordsman poses, we will get into in a second. And he does have a ball joint at the top of his waist. And before people correct me about Noob Saibot, here is Noob Saibot. He also has a ball joint at the bottom. I didn't mention it, but he has a ball joint at the bottom. Now, I don't know which of these I'm actually going to upload first. Probably going to be Noob Saibot, but... let's face it, nobody's actually going to comment on this video because barely anybody's going to watch it. If you are watching, thank you. So, yes, he's got a ball joint at the top of his chest and the bottom, which doesn't really work that well because the hoses definitely limit mobility, which is very unfortunate. You can only get that far on either side. But you can get nice up, decent amount of curl. By up, I mean bend. Hips can go forwards. They can go back. They can go out. Do you get a small amount of thigh swivel? Standard, but you do get the knee swivel. Along with the, nicely ratcheted double-jointed knee. Again, very nice bendability. You do get your ankle swivel here. And you get a hinge. And you can toe. So, Jesus, the points are quite pointy. I really should do the posability sections like up here. Swivel. Do-do-do. Look at him. He can bend. He sure is a flexible boy. Watch me. Want to see him do a magic trick? Watch. I can pop my arm out of its socket. Oh, now he doesn't want to do it? Now you don't want to do it. What are you doing to me, Cabal? Damn you. The one time I want to show it close up to a camera. There we go. So yeah. And for accessories. Oh. I guess I forgot to show the insert in the box. He also has a stand. It says Mortal Kombat on it. Which I don't ever plan to use, but here he has hook swords, which he can put in his hand, which you can put in his hands. He can't put them in his hands because he's not alive. At least, I think he's not alive. You never know. But you can put them in his hands, and he can actually look fairly dynamic, even though it's blade all the way around, not just straight forward. But, yes. It's got a bit of a handguard. Quite a bit of a handguard. I don't know if on the traditional Tibetan monk hook swords, this part is actually bladed, or if it's just all the way inside. I think also this part of the hook sword is also bladed. I'm not 100% sure. But you can also give him a second one, because thankfully he actually comes with a proper pair of them. Noob. Here's looking at you, noob. Oh, this one does not want to go into his hand very easily. There we go. So maybe we don't need... actually, try and recreate that sweet box art. There you go. Yeah. That's as close as I'm gonna get. So here's size comparisons. And there's also one here's Liu Kang. And I bring up Liu Kang specifically because I one thing, one set of dialogue where this is hard to explain, but Cabal essentially says to Liu Kang he should upgrade his weaponry, and Liu Kang says, "What, to giant hook swords?" This bothers me because Tibetan monks, like Liu Kang, used hook swords amongst their varied arsenal of the defense. Like, Tibetan monks use hook swords. So that's always bothered me. I get Liu Kang is based off Bruce Lee more than anything else, so but still, it's a nitpick I have, and I'm allowed to have it. And frankly, these are better weapons than nunchucks. Just ask Shadiversity. Shout out to Shad. But in my opinion, hook sword will be better because it's actually a bladed weapon that you can hook and disarm instead of an nunchuck. So let's go through all the rest of the size comparisons. Katana, Scorpion. Now, is a hook sword better than a regular sword? Maybe. I like the hook, but it also makes it awkward where you want to strike from. Although, but here he is with Spawn. My previous review. The blah 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 noobs I bought. Tobias Boone. Johnny Cage, who, as we mentioned, called him Carlos. Dark Raiden. Sub-Zero. And if you're wondering where Baraka is, just go watch the Noob Saibot review. But yeah. That's everything about Cabal, I believe. He's over-designed, overly complicated. But he's got cool weapons. Pretty good action figure. So, I'm happy to continue enjoying this line. And whatever the else they put out, because there's still a lot of, not even counting the guest characters bringing Spawn, there are still, just based off MK11, there's still a lot of characters that haven't gotten released. Like, way too many to Cassie, Sonya, Jackie, Jackson Briggs. Shao Kahn, Melina, who gives a fuck about the statue dude? What was his name? The guy with sand. Geras, who gives a fuck about Geras? Collector, who I also share a name with, but I swear I named myself that before I knew about Collector in Mortal Kombat 11. Frankly, they took that name for me, in my opinion. But no. Just so many characters, I could keep going. It's a gigantic roster. So. Yeah, I'm gonna keep enjoying it. And I hope you do too. So thank you for watching. I hope you have enjoyed. I know. Speedy Gonzalez, more like Slowpoke Rodriguez, am I right? Andale. It's okay. I shouldn't do that. That's insulting. But I did love Speedy Gonzalez growing up. Especially the Christmas thing. Found the Speedy Gonzalez Christmas thing once, but I couldn't find it on YouTube anymore. Yeah, now here I am just rambling. Until next time, finish him. Bye.